Councillor Glaston. Councillor Glaston, I've got reports. Thank you. In relation to the portfolio of the highways and transportation. Please ask your question.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. My question to Councillor can you hear me? I shall speak up. Is he aware that a large number of small children in my ward are greatly saddened when they learnt that Santa will not be coming to turn on their lights next year? Is he further aware that for once
tell in relation to the report, Highway Services Contract, how is that I've had the great pleasure, I'm sure my deputy will follow the line that we've continued for many years. You find that the mayor that I attend an awful lot of occasions like this, where he goes and switches lights on. Please relay your questions to the report.
I will make a comment. Is Councillor Smith aware that the once jolly Harry is now being referred to as Ebenezer Smith? However, would you not agree that it is not too late to change any thoughts he has in his mind on this matter, and that he should become like the Dickens character?
No. What is the spirit
of Christmas yet to come?
Mr. Mayor, the Christmas tree lighting programme is no longer part of my portfolio. It's been dished out to the areas a long time ago. And I think really what you've got now is the area committees which may allocate money to a programme such as that. Or you could, as Cllr and other areas have done, approach the local business people who may well be willing to pay for the lighting.
Thank you very much for that.
My children are well been known that I am Mr. Humble, you know.
That's important to be noted. Agreed. Next one is in relation to the portfolio of the neighbourhood and housing and engagement. Are there any questions? Councillor Lynch.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. It's regarding Wellbeing elsewhere property grants and the new voters allocation. Just put on record, thanks to George and the council officers who are bringing these FGOs back into use. And delighted to tell him that the government is allocating 1.768 million as a provisional allocation for 2014-15 in the new voter bonus. I'd also like George to be aware, if not only aware, the council have agreed to spend the bonus as they choose, including on frontline services and keeping council tax low. Can I ask George if you will use this new home bonus money in order to benefit the council tax payers as well and keep the council tax low?
I'd like to respond.
Yeah. Thanks for the question, Chris, and thanks for the polls. 1.76 million. That is, it's fantastic money. I think we should all agree, anything we get today coming is absolutely fantastic. I've always said that whatever game the government play, whether it's our government, your government, whoever it is, you play that game. And the new homes bonus is something that this council can really create a lot of money from. So I think where you're coming from, Chris, in terms of 1.76 million, what the way that we've got to do is that we're going to hide this away, and it isn't ring fenced at all. My personal view is it should be ring fenced.
the way it sells it, he owns bonus. I would like to say that money put into building lots more properties across the world, getting them up to the average, if you like, family, so that we get more and more and more, because then when we get the bonus, we get the bonus for 6 years on the chart, and we can actually develop and build it. It's one of the only sources of income that comes into this council now. I would like to say, personally, that I always say I'll do the best, whenever there's an opportunity, I'll go out there, I'll try and get the money in for this council. And one of the things that I would say, there's more than time for this, that's something that we have to discuss on where we have to spend that money. From my point of view, I will always argue strongly that that should go back into creating more homes.
Thank you. Finally, Policy Performance Committee Chair's report. So, are there any questions to Councillor Swittingham?
Local authorities, Energy Projects Plus, which is the environmental charity that we're working with, and Energy Helpline, which is the switching partner, that a collective switch will be put, should be put back until early 2014 to ensure that local residents could be offered the widest range of tariffs for their particular circumstances, especially those on low income and on prepayment meters, to make sure the most vulnerable households benefit. The City Region instead launched a general switching campaign in October to ensure residents could take advantage of the fixed rate deals which were available immediately and were being withdrawn by the energy companies as a result of planned price rises. I'm pleased to report, having checked up on the latest position, that it has been confirmed by Energy Projects Plus and their switching partner Energy Helpline that a collective switch for the Liverpool City Region will begin registrations in mid-January, with switching provided at the end of February. And indeed, I checked on the website of the Liverpool City Region Collective Switching Scheme just yesterday, and you can indeed join the waiting list for the collective. Any consumer can join the waiting list for the collective switch now by registering on the website lcenergyswitch.co.uk. So in conclusion, Mr. Mayor, I would agree that it was disappointing about the delay. However, it's pleasing that this collective switching process will now take place early in the new year. As with the bedroom tax, I'm happy to sit down with members from the group's offices to talk about anything we can do locally to help consumers who are suffering as a result of behaviour of the big energy companies. Happy to press this case with colleagues in the other side districts or combined authority. And finally, I would agree with Councillor Kelly when he talks about the outrageous behaviour of the big six energy companies. You know, since 2010, we've seen average energy bills increase by £300. In the light of this, that's why I hope Councillor Kelly and all his colleagues will join with me in expressing disappointment that the Coalition government has refused to back Ed Miliband's campaign to freeze energy bills until 2017. To help residents, particularly pensioners, who've been suffering too long as a result of the greed of the big six energy
companies. Thank you for that. We move on to item 10, matters referred to policy and performance. So we're on. I now move on to notice of a motion, and by what I do remind councillors that 9 o'clock 13, yes.
Can I say one thing, Mr. Mayor? I think there's a willingness to debate the first notice of motion that the group is accepting this.
Just move it to the second year. Right, in relation to 11 notices of motion, because there's motions that are against the Wirral Council Improvement Board, the Wirral Slate Hospital Living Rights. There was another notice of motion which in relation to tobacco control, which I referred to the Families of Wellbeing Performance Select Committee, so if you might be on to. First one?
Yes.
That's in relation to the improvement board.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I want to start addressing this motion by pointing out that this is not an exercise in self-congratulation, nor does it seek to suggest that we have reached the point of getting everything right, but it is a milestone on a journey. A marker that we have reached the point when we are a normal council with systems and processes in place which enable our decision making to stand up to rigorous scrutiny. A point at which our financial procedures and budgets are a true reflection of our position, and which at the same time acknowledge the enormous motive we are in the process of climbing with the ruthless and unfair cuts which are being imposed by the Tory government, and will see our budget cut by 50% by 2016. We want to assure our thanks are recorded to our officers and staff who have gone the extra mile to ensure that we reach goals and targets, and in so doing, raise the bar to our own way of working and embracing the challenge of doing so. When you appointed Anna Kanowski to carry out her investigation and report her findings yet, No harmful trap or scene, the subsequent events that unfolded. However, before the LGA were called in by the then leader Steve Ballas to assist us, working parties, which you referred to earlier this evening, were set up and they were called key lines of inquiry groups. Cross-party groups worked together and there was a commitment to work to find shared solutions to the problems we face. There was a real enthusiasm across the council, and it is in my view very sad that politics appear to have dampened that enthusiasm. Because, Mr. Mayor, whilst we are presently in the administration, and I hope we will be for many years to come, the opportunity to shape the future of the council is incumbent upon all of us as elected representatives. And I do sincerely hope going forward that opposition members will get involved, and I applaud those of you who have already done so. However, the working groups were disbanded when the improvement board set out what it saw as its priorities for council to tackle. And it's those areas that have been reviewed, reshaped and monitored to ensure that they are fit for purpose. There were five key areas. Firstly, leadership, both political and managerial, were the focus, putting in place a chief executive and leader who could drive the change. In both Bill Davies and Graham Burgess, we do have a formidable duo. Both are committed to a vision of a council that has clear direction and purpose and delivers services that the residents of Wirral value and are affordable. To support that vision, the Improvement Board's second priority was a clear and updated corporate plan, which clearly set out the direction of travel for the authority, and that plan was agreed by council last month, setting out our high-level objectives and key priorities of safeguarding the vulnerable in the borough, attracting jobs and investment, and narrowing the gap in life expectancy between the east and west. The corporate plan contained our medium-term financial strategy, showing how our finances will be deployed to deliver those priorities. And work is now gathering a pace, Mr. Mayor, in bringing forward the departmental action plans. Number three for the improvement board was corporate governance and decision making, an area that had been the focus of the Cllr investigation. Subsequently, our corporate governance has been refreshed. We have made amendments to our constitution, including our scheme of delegation to officers. We have strengthened our scrutiny function by setting up policy and performance pre-decision scrutiny and before they come to cabinet. And key in this area is the audit governance statement, which external audit has declared an open and transparent statement and a good reflection of Wirral Council. We have established a policy council in order that we can agree priorities together and refresh the corporate plan going forward. The fourth area the improvement board highlighted was budget and financial stability. Mr. Mayor, the council faces unprecedented challenges, but we are proud that the budget that has been agreed here tonight does address the priorities we've set and protects residents whose needs are real and have been identified by them through the What Really Matters consultation process. The people of Wirral have spoken and we listened and acted on their concerns. Cabinet now receives monthly monitoring reports to ensure that sound forecasting and financial planning is embedded across the council. Whilst this priority remains a concern, as I highlighted earlier, that is no different than any other council up and down this country at the moment who faces the massive challenge of having its finances cut in the way we have. On safeguarding of critical service, there have been significant improvements across adult social care, and children and adult services have in place a three-year transformation plan to ensure budget safeguarding services for the most vulnerable. We perform excellently in economic regeneration. We've heard that from Cabinet Member tonight, and investment, and we are proud of the role we will play in the combined authority of promoting improved transport, employment and skills for the benefit of rural residents. We believe, Mr. Mayor, we are functioning as a normal council. It was Anna Klonowski who said, in Wirral, the abnormal has become normal. We don't believe that label can be attached here now. The improvement board will be back in March, and we want to see progress against the next steps they identified, such as embedding the culture change and ensuring compliance with new procedures and continuing to meet our financial challenges as well as remodelling this council. Challenges we look forward to tackling as the council goes on its journey of continuous improvement. There are many and numerous changes which have been put in place since the Improvement Board began working with 20 months ago, Mr. Mayor. And the top 50 changes at Wirral Council will be circulated to all members of the Council early in the new year. It is the season of goodwill, Mr. Mayor, and I ask members to reflect about a time when we may be retired and read about the outstanding Council that Wirral hopefully will become. Wouldn't it be good to know that in some small way we were all part of the change that made a difference and contributed to that success? Before I urge all members of the Council to be part of that change and support our motion, I do want to just turn my attention to the amendments that have been put forward by the Liberal Democrats. Phil, we can't agree to the deletion of paragraph 2 as you request. Because, Phil, we are very proud of the fact that this has been the fastest turnaround identified by any local authority in the position that we found ourselves. And therefore, we're not willing to remove that from our notice of motion. And we're also not willing to remove paragraph 4, where we are absolutely committed to ensuring that all elected members, as far as they want to be, and I really hope in the new year that members will be, in terms of through the Policy and Performance Committee and our mission events, in helping to shape the future of this Council. New paragraph 5 is found by us. In fact, if you want to add what you've got in your notice of motion as friendly amendments to what is already there, we're very happy to accept them. But Mr. Mayor, in closing, I would just want to say we are moving forward now on this journey. We've come a long way, and I hope when members see this top 50 changes at Wirral Council, that they will be able to really see the meat on the bones of what has been done. And I pay tribute to everybody, the leadership of, you know, of Phil Davies in driving this forward with the leadership team, the senior leadership team of the you know, of officers, and it's all officers across the council. I don't want to name anybody, particularly Mr. Mayor, because I really do believe that we have a fantastic team effort. So I will have motion. Thank you.